Good morning, boys and girls, and welcome to 2021. Happy New Year. I hope everybody had a safe and wonderful holiday, but the New Year is here. And if you want anything good to happen in this year, you got to put it into action starting today, starting yesterday. Look, I've been doing this a long, long time. I know this time of year, most people would like to lose some body fat. This will not change until we die. I know this, you know this, everybody knows this. There are exceptions, but most people, including myself, would like to always this time of year to trim up just a little bit. Some people need to lose 100 pounds or more. Both are the same, and both will come down to what you eat and what you drink. I know a lot of people want to start exercising this time of year. I'm all for it. I think everybody should exercise regularly. It's very important for so many reasons, so many different reasons. But it is not going to fix all the problems when it comes to losing body fat. Most of that will be fixed by improving what you eat and what you drink. So now that I got that out of the way, I want to hit up a couple of really important points. This first one's super important, so listen up. Every time food and beverage goes down your throat, it counts as a meal. You've got to train your brain to think this way, because no matter how big, no matter how small, one little thing going down the chute has an effect hormonally on your bodies. It's not about the calories in that one thing, because small things, everything counts as a meal. It doesn't matter if it's an M&M, a Hershey's Kiss, or one potato chip, a French fry at your kid's meal, a shot of whiskey, a glass of wine, a piece of fruit even healthy stuff. All of it counts as a meal. A lot of people are unaware that they snack all day long, and it's a big, big problem. You've got to count everything as a meal. The second point of this is the fact that the more meals you have each day, the more your body is going to crave food, whether you need it or not. And a lot of people are eating more food and drinking more food than they actually need. Hence, that's why a lot of people have a lot of excess body fat. We don't need that much food. I would argue that most people only need 2 or 3 meals at most a day. It is important what you're eating. It is important the calories, the total calories you eat each day is important. But my argument is, and the whole point of this, is that the more feedings, the more meals, quote unquote, the more meals that go down your throat each day, the more you are going to want more food. We're just like animals. I have a cat and a dog. Me and my wife have a cat and a dog. We feed them 2 times a day. They're used to that. If we feed them 1 time a day, they're pissed off and they want more food because they're used to getting fed 2 times a day. But if next month or next week we start feeding them 3 times a day, pretty soon they're going to expect 3 meals a day. Even though they don't need it, they're fine where they're at with 2 meals, but they are going to get used to feeding and having a 3-meal-a-day regimen. That's what they're going to expect. Their bodies will crave it. We've done the same thing. We eat and drink way too damn much. Most people in America are overweight and fat, and most people want to lose that. And it's just like Susan Powers back in the day. Stop the insanity. If you really, really want to help yourself, you've got to realize that we've all created monsters, and I'm no different. It's easy during the holidays. I snacked on a lot of stuff all day long. I wasn't doing a whole lot. There was a lot of wonderful food around, and I love food just as much as anybody else, but we have to have control. Look, nothing in the future will change if we don't make change. This is the hardest thing that I know to do, but if you can control what you put in your mouth, you can control damn near anything.